صلوات الله محمد وآل محمد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. يا علي يا عظيم يا غفور يا رحيم، أنت الرب العظيم الذي ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. وهذا شهر عظمته وكرمته وشرفته وفضلته على الشهور، وهو شهر الذي فرضت صيامه عليه، وهو شهر رمضان الذي أنزلت فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان، وجعلت فيه ليلة القدر وجعلتها خيرا من ألف شهر. فيا ذا المن ولا يمن عليك، من علي بفكاك رقبتي من النار في من تمن عليه، وأدخلني الجنة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم رب شهر رمضان الذي أنزلت فيه القرآن وافترضت على عبادك فيه الصيام، صل على محمد وآل محمد، وارزقني حج بيتك الحرام في عامي هذا وفي كل عام، واغفر لي تلك الذنوب العظام فإنه لا يغفرها غيرك يا رحمن يا علام. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم إني أفتتح الثناء بحمدك، وأنت مصدد للصواب بمنك، وأيقنت أنك أنت أرحم الراحمين في موضع العفو والرحمة، وأشد المعاقبين في موضع النكال والنقمة، وأعظم المتجبرين في موضع الكبرياء والعظمة. اللهم أذنت لي في دعائك ومسألتك، فاسمع يا سميع مدحتي، وأجب يا رحيم دعوتي، وأقل يا غفور عثرتي. فكم يا إلهي من كربة قد فرجتها، وهموم قد كشفتها، وعثرة قد أقلتها، ورحمة قد نشرتها، وحلقة بلاء قد فككتها. الحمد لله الذي لم يتخذ صاحبة ولا ولدا، ولم يكن له شريك في الملك، ولم يكن له ولي من الذل، وكبره تكبيرا. الحمد لله بجميع محامده كلها، على جميع نعمه كلها. الحمد لله الذي لا مضاد له في ملكه، ولا منازع له في أمره. الحمد لله الذي لا شريك له في خلقه، ولا شبيه له في عظمته. الحمد لله الفاشي في الخلق، أمره وحمده الظاهر بالكرم مجدوه، الباسط بالجود يده، الذي لا تنقص خزائنه ولا تزيده كثرة العطاء إلا جودا وكرما، إنه هو العزيز الوهاب. اللهم إني أسألك قليلا من كثير، مع حاجة بي إليه عظيمة، وغناك عنه قديم، وهو عندي كثير، وهو عليك سهل يسير. اللهم إن عفوك عن ذنبي، وتجاوزك عن خطيئتي، وصفحك عن ظلمي، وسترك على قبيح عملي، وحلمك عن كثير جرمي، عندما كان من خطي وعمدي أطمعني في أن أسألك ما لا أستوجبه منك الذي رزقتني من رحمتك وأغريتني من قدرتك وعرفتني من إجابتك فصرت عدوك آمنا وأسألك مستأنسا لا خائفا ولا وجلا مدلا عليك فيما قصدت فيه إليك فإن أبطى عني عتبت بجحلي عليك ولعل الذي أبطى عني هو خير لي لعلمك بعاقبة الأمور فلم أر مولا كريما أصبر على عبد لئيم منك علي يا ربي إنك تدعوني فأولي عنك وتتحبب إلي فأتبغض إليك وتتودد إلي فلا أقبل منك كأن لي التطول عليك فلم يمنعك ذلك من الرحمة لي والإحسان إلي والتفضل علي بجودك وكرمك فارحم عبدك الجاهل وجد عليه بفضل إحسانك إنك جواد كريم الحمد لله مالك الملك مجرئ الفلك مسخر الرياح فالق الإصباح ديان الدين رب العالمين الحمد لله على حلمه بعد علمه والحمد لله على عفوه بعد قدرته والحمد لله على طول أناته في غضبه وهو قادر على ما يريد الحمد لله خالق الخلق باسط الرزق فالق الإصباح ذي الجلال والإكرام والفضل والإنعام الذي بعد فلا يرى وقرب فشهد النجوى تبارك وتعالى الحمد لله الذي ليس له منازع يعادله ولا شبيه يشاكله ولا ظهير يعاضده قهر بعزته الأعزى وتواضع لعظمته العظمى فبلغ بقدرته ما يشاء الحمد لله الذي يجيبني حين أنادي ويستر علي كل عورة وأنا أعصيه ويعظم النعمة علي فلا أجازي فكم من موهبة هنيئة قد أعطاني وعظيمة مخوفة قد كفاني وبهجة مونقة قد أراني فأثني عليه حامدا وأذكره مسبحا الحمد لله الذي لا يحتك حجابه ولا يغلق بابه ولا يرد سائله ولا يخيب آمله الحمد لله الذي يؤمن الخائفين وينجي الصالحين ويرفع المستضعفين ويضع المستكبرين ويهلك ملوكا ويستخلف آخرين والحمد لله قاسم الجبارين مبير الظالمين مدرك الهاربين نكال الظالمين صريخ المستصرخين موضع حاجة الطالبين معتمد المؤمنين الحمد لله الذي من خشيته ترعد السماء وسكانها وترجف الأرض وعمارها وتموج البحار ومن يسبح في غمراتها الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله الحمد لله الذي يخلق ولم يخلق ويرزق ولا يرزق ويطعم ولا يطعم ويميت الأحياء ويحيي الموتى وهو حي لا يموت بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك وأمينك وصفيك وحبيبك خيرتك من خلقك وحافظ سرك ومبلغ رسالاتك أفضل وأحسن وأجمل وأكمل وأزكى وأنمى وأطيب وأطهر وأسنى وأكثر ما صليت وباركت وترحمت وتحننت وسلمت على أحد من عبادك وأنبيائك ورسلك وصفوتك وأهل الكرامة عليك من خلقك اللهم وصل على علي أمير المؤمنين ووصي الرسول رب العالمين عبدك ووليك وأخي رسولك وحجتك على خلقك وآيتك الكبرى والنبع العظيم وصل على صديقة الطاهرة فاطمة الزهراء سيدة نساء العالمين وصل على سبتي الرحمة وإمام الحدى الحسن والحسين سيدي شباب أهل الجنة وصل على أئمة المسلمين علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والخلف الهادي المهدي حججك على عبادك وأمنائك في بلادك صلاة كثيرة دائمة اللهم وصل على ولي أمرك القائم المؤمل والعدل المنتظر وحفه بملائكتك المقربين وأيده بروح القدس يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعله الداعي إلى كتابك والقائم بدينك استخلفه في الأرض كما استخلفت الذين من قبله مكن له دينه الذي ارتضيته له أبدله من بعد خوف أمنا يعبدك لا يشرك بك شيئا اللهم أعزه وأعزز به وانصره وانتصر به وانصره نصرا عزيزا وافتح له فتحا يسيرا واجعل له من لدنك سلطانا نصيرا اللهم أظهر به دينك وسنة نبيك حتى لا يستخفي بشيء من الحق مخافة أحد من الخالق اللهم إنا نرغب إليك في دولة كريمة تعز بها الإسلام وأهله وتذل بها النفاق وأهله وتجعلنا فيها من الدعاة إلى طاعتك والقادة إلى سبيلك وترزقنا بها كرامة الدنيا والآخرة اللهم ما عرفتنا من الحق فحملنا وما قصرنا عنه فبلغنا اللهم المن به شعثنا واشعب به صدعنا ورتق به فتقنا وكثر به قلتنا وعزز به ذلتنا وأغن به عائلنا واقض به عن مغرمنا واجبر به فقرنا وسد به خلتنا ويسر به عسرنا وبيض به وجوهنا وفك به أسرنا وانجح به طلبتنا وانجز به مواعيدنا واستجب به دعوتنا واعطنا به سؤلنا وبلغنا به من الدنيا والآخرة آمالنا واعطنا به فوق رغبتنا يا خير المسؤولين وأوسع المعطين اشفي به صدورنا وأذهب به غيظ قلوبنا واهدنا به لما اختلف فيه من الحق بإذنك إنك تهدي من تشاء إلى صراط مستقيم وانصرنا به على عدوك وعدونا إله الحق آمين
اللهم إنا نشكو إليك فقد نبينا صلواتك عليه وآله وغيبة ولينا وكثرة عدونا وقلة عددنا وشدة الفتن بنا وتداهر الزمان علينا، فصل على محمد وآله وعنا على ذلك بفتح منك تعجله وبدر تكشفه ونصر تعزه وسلطان حق تظهره ورحمة منك تجللناها وعافية منك تلبسناها برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم برحمتك في الصالحين فأدخلنا، وفي عليين فارفعنا، وبكأس من معين من عين سلسبيل فاسقنا، ومن الحور العين برحمتك فزوجنا، ومن الولدان المخلدين كأنهم لؤلؤ مكنون فأخدمنا، ومن ثمار الجنة ولحوم الطير فأطعمنا، ومن ثياب السندس والحرير والاستبرق فألبسنا، وليلة القدر وحج بيتك الحرام وقتلا في سبيلك فوفق لنا، وصالح الدعاء والمسألة فاستجب لنا، وإذا جمعت الأولين والآخرين يوم القيامة فارحمنا، وبراءة من النار فاكتب لنا، وفي جهنم فلا تغل لنا، وفي عذابك بك وهوانك فلا تبتلنا، ومن الزقوم والضريع فلا تطعمنا، ومع الشياطين فلا تجعلنا، وفي النار على وجوهنا فلا تكببنا، ومن ثياب النار وسرابيل القطران فلا تلبسنا، ومن كل سوء يا لا إله إلا أنت، بحق لا إله إلا أنت فنجنا. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم إني أسألك أن تجعل فيما تقضي وتقدر من الأمر المحتوم في الأمر الحكيم، من القضاء الذي لا يرد ولا يبدل، أن تكتبني من حجاج بيتك الحرام، المبرور حجهم، المشكور سعيهم، المغفور ذنوبهم، المكفر عن سيئاتهم، وأن تجعل فيما تقضي وتقدر أن تطيل عمري في خير وعافية، وتوسع في رزقي، وتجعلني ممن تنتصر به لدينك، ولا تستبدل بي غيري. أعوذ بجلال وجهك الكريم أن ينقضي عني شهر رمضان أو يطلع الفجر من ليلتي هذه، ولك قبلي تبعة أو ذنب تعذبني عليه. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم أدخل على أهل القبور السرور. اللهم أغني كل فقير. اللهم اشبع كل جائع. اللهم اكس كل عريان. اللهم اقض دين كل مدين. اللهم فرج عن كل مكروب. اللهم رد كل غريب. اللهم فك كل أسير. اللهم اصلح كل فاسد من أمور المسلمين. اللهم اشف كل مريض. اللهم سد فقرنا بغناك. اللهم غير سوء حالنا بحسن حالك. اللهم اقض عنا الدين، واغننا من الفقر، إنك على كل شيء قدير. ما صلى عليه.
محمد وآل محمد صلوات. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. المرحومة مرضية شا was buried earlier today in Birmingham. Let us recite Surah Al-Fatiha for the marhuma. Al-Fatiha. Kindly remember the marhuma in your du'as and as well as with namazi hadiyah mayyat. Notice is hereby given that the annual general meeting of the Jamaat will be held on Saturday, the 15th of April, commencing at 10 p.m. here at the transition site, or as well as known as the Caveland, 17 Clifton Road, Birmingham. The agenda, minutes of the previous AGM, the accounts, as well as all the subcommittee reports, inshallah, will be circulated in due course. Mominin, as I had mentioned, that we will be updating you regarding the iftar niyas. So if I can kindly ask the AV team to put the poster on the screen. So the good news is that, alhamdulillah, we've had 15 donors already, or part donors, which will cover for 15 or half of the month of the iftars for this holy month. The bad news is that we still have half to go. So all those red, as you can see, are all the iftars that we still need to fill. So please do kindly donate generously. As mentioned previously, the cost for an iftar, it's a lot than it was last year. But as you all are aware, that prices have gone up. Inflation, our energy prices have more than doubled as well. So you can expect with food as well. So the prices for the cost of iftar is £1,800 for a normal weekday, and £2,000 for the weekends as well as the nights of Qadr. That comes to equivalent to about £2, £53 per person when we're having iftar at our mosque. So it's nothing compared to, you know, what we would be, you know, paying when we're going out for a meal. So please do donate generously. You can solely sponsor an iftar, or you can get together as a family or and friends, or whatever little you can, please do donate. We have sent out the links before. Inshallah, we will do so again. Or you can please see the treasury desks to donate generously. As well as the iftar niyas, we also have the Ramadan relief, and these are the only two funds that we only run during the month of Ramadan. Mominin, as was mentioned, the Ramadan relief fund is a £50 fund that will feed a family of five for the whole month of Ramadan. The food packs will enable the families to cook for themselves, or in other countries, iftars are being cooked and being supplied to the families to make it easier for them. So please do donate generously. A link was sent out earlier today. Donate whatever little you can, if not £50, or please support by buying from the stalls that we've got outside in the car park, as well as you normally see Muslim Uncle Khoja coming around with his basket as well. So whatever little you donate is going to a very, very good cause. So please do keep donating generously, and inshallah we will be updating you as we proceed towards the holy month, inshallah. Our program tomorrow, Sunday the 26th of March, being the fifth night of the holy month of Ramadan, will commence at 5:30 p.m. with the Quran Khani. Thereafter, Dua Iftitah at 6:30, lecture by Sayyid Aliraza Naqvi at 6:55, and ending with Maghrib Ain Salat as well as full iftar. Please note, on Sundays, as is our usual practice, the whole program will take place before Maghrib Ain Salat, and inshallah will end with full iftar. Another humble reminder that the clocks will be going forward tonight by an hour. So Fajr Salat tomorrow, our time for Fajr Salat is 5:26 a.m. But as was announced, that our Fajr Salat takes place 15 minutes after Awal time every day here in this hall for both the ladies and the gents. So please do participate in Fajr Salat. And finally, tonight's iftar has been sponsored for the Isal Thawab of all the Marhumin, whose names are now on the screen. So if we can kindly recite under the Surah Fatiha for them, as well as all our Marhumin, Al-Fatiha. Thank you. Thank you very much. Momini, just before you invite Sayed, again, if I can kindly trouble you to please come forward, all the brothers sitting on the back there, the halls will get busy later on like they did yesterday. So if you can kindly please come a little bit forward, this side of the hall, lots of space, this side as well. Please come forward and let's invite Sayed for tonight's lecture with three loud salat ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.
Really? أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين حبيبي إله رب العالمين أبي القاسم محمد اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا أما بعد سلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Yesterday, a young boy came to me when I was there after the lecture was over, and all he did was did this to me. I was above 14 minutes yesterday, and I take ownership and I take responsibility and accountability of taking your time more than I was supposed to take. So I'm very sorry for that. Inshallah ta'ala, today I will be very strictly on my time and we will complete the day's program, inshallah ta'ala. Yesterday we spoke about how to be responsible for your own learning. How to be independent in your thought. How to be independent in your own thinking. When birds, and listen to me carefully, my dear brothers and sisters, because sometimes I don't want to expand on things that I'm speaking about, but I'm sure, because I believe one thing which is very, very true to me at least, and I believe that all of you individuals sitting in this room and beyond are special individuals in this world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted you with so much, has granted you with so much. So much love, so much compassion, so much mercy, so much intellect, so much aql, so many experiences in life, that only if you had to go and sit on your own and try to look for yourself, you will see that you shine, that you are worth it, and that not only that you shine, you know, there is something called selflessness in life. And what does it mean? I remember in my graduation in London, when I graduated from Madrasa Sayyid Al-Khuy, I gave a speech in Arabic in front of all my ustad and my teachers, and I praised my father, because it is because of my father and my mother that I today exist with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And at that time I said, my father huwa hiya sham'atu allati tahriqu nafsaha litudhi'aha lil-akharin. That my father is a candle which burnt itself to give light to others. And so selflessness means that you are sometimes a candle, my dear brothers and sisters. You shine and you give light to others. But sometimes you can even be an ice cream. You know, because you have to be selfish at times. But if you look at yourself and if you look within yourself, you will see that through you, others can develop. Through you, others can become what they want to become. Through you, you can spread light as much as you want to spread in this world. And therefore, it is highly, highly important that birds, and this is what I want to speak about, very profound. Birds who are born in a cage think that flying is an illness. Can I repeat this? Birds that are born in the cage think that flying is an illness. The birds were created to fly, not to be put in a cage. We captured them. We put them in the cage. And now we tell them, look, that bird is flying. And it says, no. It's an illness. You and I, my dear brothers and sisters, were born to fly. We were born to realize our own potentials. We were born to realize our own capabilities and capacities and abilities and power. And sometimes, you know, and this is in many hadiths, by the way, many, many hadiths, in which the Holy Prophet, Imam Ali, all the other a'imma salamullahi alayhim ajma'in, have guided us and have told us, do not become sheep. Do not become sheep. Why? What does a sheep fear most in his or her life? Can you guess, anyone? The sheep, all its life, fears the wolf. Yes? You know, I got feedback from home. They said to me, why do you keep on saying yes or no? I say, well, I feel connected to the people I'm speaking to. So when I ask them yes or no, they give me a reply. Yes or no? Thank you very much. The sheep, my dear brothers and sisters, its whole life fears the wolf, correct? Only to be eaten by the shepherd. I'm not going to expand on this. I will not expand on this because, you know, it's fuel and oxygen for people who want to use it. A sheep, all its life fears the wolf, only to be eaten by the shepherd. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made me and you free of thought and independence, then why should I not use it? Why should I not take advantage of my God-given talents and powers and rise to the challenge that Allah has given me in this world? We are living in a broken world today. I mean, there is no doubt about it. And I have met so many people and I have spoken to so many people who have got everything in life. Who have got everything in life. What they don't have is inner peace. What they don't have is peace inside. When I was a young kid of 16, 17, people who were powerful, people who were rich, people who wore good clothes, I was impressed by them. But as I grew up more and more and more and gathered experiences and saw the world from all angles, I said to myself, hold on, right now I'm 54 years old. What matters to me is my internal peace. And my internal peace will only come to me when I take responsibility of what I am learning. When I take responsibility of what I am practicing. When I can stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say to Allah, Ya Allah, whether I am wrong in my path or no, I have chosen this path because of the evidences that I have got on my own behalf. Because of the guidances that I felt were for me to shine on this earth. And that is why, my dear brothers and sisters, it is highly, highly, highly important. For me at least, and I'm inviting you to think about this. As I said on my first lecture, I am not here to teach anyone anything. All I'm here to do is make you think. That's it. And the more you think, you see, there is an onion. Have you all seen an onion? Yes, an onion has got layers upon layers upon layers upon layers. You take a knife, you cut the onion, you see the core of the onion in the middle. Yes or no? Now here is the thing. Thank you. Now here's the thing. When you and I were born, we were empty. We were empty, weren't we? Completely empty. We were born naked. We were raised. Our parents came. Recommendation by the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. That when a child is born, pick the child up and on the right ear say, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. On the left ear say, Iqama. On the right ear say, Adhan. On the left ear say, Iqama. And then of course we philosophize the whole concept of this and say, life is so short as if the time between the Adhan and the Iqama and finish, your life's over, go to your grave. We were born with nothing. Nothing. And then we were raised. Our parents taught us La ilaha illallah. Our parents taught us Muhammadun Rasulullah. Our parents taught us Aliyun Waliullah. Our parents taught us all the good things that they were supposed to teach us. And so we adopted this Islam. We adopted this faith. We adopted this value. They said to us, you know, I'll give you a personal example, okay? Look at this. Just think about it. When I say to you, think independently and have power of your own thought, let me give you an example of my own family. None of our boys, my family, none of my boys are allowed to wear a yellow shirt. By the way, none of our boys are allowed to wear yellow shirt. And this was a ruling from my mother. And when one day I gathered the courage and I went and I asked her, I said, Mom, you know, why? Why? What has color got to do with anything? Why am I not allowed to wear yellow? Okay, tomorrow when I have a child, when he says to me, Mom, Dad, I want to wear a yellow shirt, what do I tell? I said, tell him forbidden to wear yellow shirt. And I dug in and I dug in and I dug in and I asked, Mom, please tell me. And she said, you know something? One day, your eldest brother was traveling in a bus and he was wearing a yellow shirt and he got into an accident. He was almost dead. And from that day onwards, yellow is an enemy to me. And therefore, I have associated the color yellow with calamity. Am I making sense? Now what, is this religious? Is this a rule from the Holy Prophet of Islam? Is this a qanun or the rule from Imam Ali alayhi salam? But this ritual, not only ritual, this rule has stayed till today. Do you wear yellow shirt? You can't, that's my boy there. No yellow shirts. But the thing is, this is a family value you and I were born with. So we were born with an Islamic value that our parents nurtured us to follow and believe. We were born with certain rituals, familial values that we were born with. So what happens is, when you were born, you are the core of the onion. And suddenly, one layer of family comes in. Then the layer of religiosity comes in. Then the layer of culture comes in. Then the layer of schooling comes in. Then the layer of education comes in. Then the layer of love comes in. Then the layer of hatred comes in. Then the layer, so many layers, layers upon layers upon layers come and cover your core. My dear brothers and sisters, by the time you realize you are fully covered by the layers of the onions of your life. And now, when someone like me comes and attempts to make myself and all of you think and reflect and go back on life, we take a knife and we start cutting that onion. And when we do, toxicity and gases are released from that onion, and I start to have tears in my eyes. Because I'll tell you one thing, and this is a very powerful thing I'm telling you. Please try it out. The more you dig deep into yourself, into your own traumas, your insecurities, your non-confidence, whatever it may be, the more you visit yourself, the more you will get scared. The more you will start to realize and think for yourself, is this really who I am? Is this really who I am? Is this really what I stand for? Is this really what I follow? Is this really how I worship? Is this really how I follow my Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is this really how I recite my du'as? Is this really how I connect to my Lord? You will shed a tear or two. But as I told you in my first and second lecture, that the past is there to look at it, and look at it forgivingly, to learn from it and to move forward. And so when Allah gives you and me the opportunity of becoming shepherds instead of sheep, take that challenge. Because every Ramadan comes, every Thursday comes, every Friday comes, every single day when Allah gives you a life, He whispers in your ears and He tells you, I have faith in you. I trust you to climb the mountains. But if you want to move the mountains tomorrow, start by picking up stones today. Only then will you be able to go to the top of the mountain, only to realize that there's another mountain you have to climb. Life is a journey that never ends till you visit your Lord. God knows where, whether it's going to be in the grave or whether you will be resurrected on the day of judgment, and we will be standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where our books will be open and we will be given the opportunity by Allah to say, here, read your book and see what your life was like and tell me what can I do for you here now. There are so many verses in the Holy Quran, aren't they? They say, Ya Allah, please give me some time. Let me, you know, when I'm dead. This is Quran, by the way. In Quran, there is a verse which says when the person is dead, when we take the soul and the ruh of the individual will scream and say, Ya Allah, please give me fa'asaddaqa wa akum min as-salihin. Give me some more time. Let me go to this earth. I will do nothing but good. And Allah will say, وَلَنْ يُؤَخِّرَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهَا. And when time is up, when you have to now not go back on this earth because you had the chance and the opportunity, God will say, وَلَنْ يُؤَخِّرَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهَا. Sorry. You will not be able to get even a second back to go and do anything good. Because when I gave you the opportunity, what did you do? You were busy, being busy in life. You did not take the opportunity of sitting in a corner in your house in the darkness of your soul and think about what you are. You did not take responsibility of your own learning. You did not take responsibility of your own actions. All you had was a victim mindset. I blame others. I blame events. I blame society, forgetting that I am part of that society. I produce excuses and I have reasons and justifications of my actions. And I am always in denial sometimes. You know, when we speak about relationships, inshallah ta'ala, in the next 3 or 4 nights, it depends on how we are moving. I have 10 minutes remaining, my brothers and sisters. It depends on how we are moving. We will see that in a relationship, the 3 common things that come out in the open is either blame, excuses, or denial. We will talk about criticism and stonewalling and control, all this later on. But these three things that come to my mind, to the mind of a victim is what? That victim, you know, mindset that I am a victim of society. I am sorry for myself. I feel sorry for myself. I feel I have to go and sit down and ask questions about my own life to someone else who is living his or her life, herself or himself. Either blame or excuses or denial. And Allah says to you, innaka inna inni khalaqna, I have created you. I have created you as the ashraful makhluqat. I have given you aql and I have given you a fu'ad and a soul so that you can really ponder over life. You can see what life is. And you can visit yourselves. You know, because this is the truth in life, isn't it? It's the truth in life that when I am buried in my own onions, and I'm buried in my own society, and I'm buried in my own things. All I know of myself is my name. And this name is not you, by the way. And I asked you a question that day when I say I, who do you mean? When I say I, who do you mean? And so my brothers and sisters, sheep fears his whole life, the wolf, only to be eaten by the shepherd. When you choose a shepherd, be a shepherd yourself of your life. When you want to write a biography of your own life, pick up the pen and hold it in your own hands. Don't give the pen to someone else to write your life biography. It is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has a pen and he has given it to you to write your own life. You can't write my life biography for me. All you will do is write my achievements, if at all I have any. And this is, if you look at those biographies written of Nelson Mandela and the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, there is so much information about these individuals, but who is writing it? I am writing the biography of Nelson Mandela, what? His achievements. I'm sure he was interviewed, of course, when biography was written. And you know how biographies are written of politicians and stuff. You know better than I do. And so when you would like your life to be your life, hold your pen in your own hand and write your own life with your own hands. Taking the guidance from the Quran and the Ahlul Bayt, salamullahi alayhi majma'in. But remember, I am promising this to you because I strongly believe in it, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at each and every one of us and says to us, you people I have created as the most special human beings on this earth. And as an example, there may be 8 billion people on this earth. Yes or no? But there is only one you, my friend. There is nobody like you. There is no comparison. There is no way I can compare you to anyone else in this life. But don't we hear this in our society? I in fact tell my own children sometimes, in my own madrasa, I say, if this child can do it, why can't you do it? If his boy could do it, why couldn't you do it? If this girl has done it, why couldn't you do it? Don't you understand that each child says to you, please understand me. Me, I am an individual. Don't compare me with others. So my dear brothers and sisters, take charge of your own lives. Take charge of your own actions. Take charge of your own thoughts and emotions. Take charge of it. Because if you don't think for yourself, I promise you, I will think for you. And if I think for you, you will have to walk my footsteps. There was a father and a child walking on a beach. Listen to this. And the father says to the child, son, watch your steps when you walk on this earth. And the son says, no, dad, you watch your steps when you walk on this earth. He says, why? He says, because I follow your footsteps. This is the conditioning of society, by the way. Conditioning of society. The son is walking on the footsteps of the father. Where in the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when he was talking to the Christians, he says, why do you believe in these things? Why do you worship idols? They say, we found our fathers worshiping these idols. I have 5 more minutes. I have not even started today's session. Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad salawat. I am certainly very, very passionate to see every individual, of course, starting from me, to grow, to become what they are supposed to become, to climb the mountains, to do anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen for me and you to do. How about if we take all challenges as opportunities of growth? How about if you took pain as challenges for us to grow? How about if we stopped asking this question, why me? The question I would ask you, why not you? You know, there was a time when I had a scare in my own health. I did a blood test, and the blood test had a very high marking of whatever, some high markers. And the doctor said, my friend, I think you have cancer. Me and my wife were there in the surgery, and we are hearing, oh, we have cancer. Okay. Now, how do you even receive this news? I have cancer. Okay. What do we do? So anyway, we go home, and the first thing I tell my wife is, do not tell my sisters, because they are big drama at home. You know what I mean? They will start sleepless nights, and they will do all the du'as that Allah, that they can think of. Don't tell them. And I don't want you to discuss this with me or anyone until we get our treatment plan. Yes? And then one day she says to me, but Ali, listen to me. I want you to pray to Allah. I said, what do I ask for? She says, ask for you to be well again. Ask for this cancer to be removed. Do dua. I said, that is the only silah I have at the moment. That's the only weapon I have in this moment, yes? Yes, but please guide me and tell me, what do I ask for? How can I speak to Allah and say, Allah, I don't want this illness in my life? Because what if he turns back and asks me and says to me, I gave you eyes, did you ask me why I gave you eyes? I gave you legs, did you ask me why I gave you legs? I gave you power of speech. Did you ask me why you gave me the power of speech? Today, when he's giving me something that I think is a dangerous illness, I am asking him, why me? Well, he can turn around and ask me, why not you? Why not you? And only if we understand that the relationship between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so special, only if you realize, and I realize this, the world doesn't matter. If I find myself and lose the world, I become the winner. Let me lose the world, but at least I have found myself. And when I go home to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I can say to him, I have become one. And this is important, my dear brothers and sisters. Today's biggest message for me to you is take charge of your lives. This holy month of Ramadan, I told you, let us connect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us organize our heads. Let us organize our minds. Let us be in the present. Let us connect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if He and I were sitting in the same place. And when you talk to God, there will be 200 people sitting in this room. But when you talk to God, try and be you and Him without even listening to the murmurs of the 200 people around you. And you can do it. And nobody should tell you you can't. Because you are the shepherd of your own life. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us tawfiq to actually realize our potentials and power that God has granted us. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our hearts melt when we hear the name of Allah. Where to make our hearts at awe when we listen to the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we pray to Allah, and we are today grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for having made us, every individual, as an individual. And we pray for our marhumin. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
As-salamu alayka ya Rasool Allah, as-salamu alayka ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, as-salamu alayka ya Fatimah al-Zahra, Sayyidati Nisa'i al-Alamin, as-salamu alayka ya Hasan al-Mujtaba, as-salamu alayka ya Aba Abdullah al-Husayn, وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته السلام عليك يا علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر السلام عليك يا غريب الغرباء وبعيد المدى السلطان بن الحسن مولانا علي بن موسى الرضا كن شفيئنا وشفيء والدينا جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته السلام عليك يا محمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي السلام عليك يا صاحب العصر والزمان السلام عليك يا خليفة الرحمن السلام عليك يا شريك القرآن السلام عليك يا كعبة الإيمان السلام عليك يا إمامنا وإمام الإنس والجان أجر الله لك ما وعدك من النصر وظهور الأمر ورحمة الله وبركاته بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم كل وليك الحجة ابن الحسن صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك توعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين